Then we are just starting this our 1 month retreat.
Then they know him. Mando Tabotidon, Salunoni, then it took her. It took her, took her in Mando, took her in Ugi. They call him a genius.
So during this 1 month retreat, of course, that we have the Mwendo, the preliminary four foundation practice, and then the Talung, the channels practice, and then the Dzogchen Tekel, where there is the preparation and the actual practice, and then the conclusion part. In this way, we have four different classes. So here, everybody has just come here to carry through this practice, the spiritual path to follow, you know, in a proper way. So according to that, one should have that kind of pure motivation or intention relating with one's body, speech, mind, try to do the practice and maintain everything in a more pure and perfect way. So the Dharma, the Chö, which means the Dharma, the teachings, first of all, it is important that one have to just understand, one have to know. And just only having that understanding, you know, not necessarily that one could to liberate, so one have to apply into practice. See, in that way, just where one have to concentrate how one can do the proper practice. These days, many people just think, you know, one just listen for Dharma teachings and one know a little bit, and then one started just, you know, teaching others, and then one think, I know the Dharma, but it doesn't mean that one really knows anything about Dharma. So most important is that what one really hear, the Dharma teaching, one have to really apply into practice. So that practice, that which one need to apply just months and years and almost like whole lifetime, and then at the end one could have that kind of, you know, accomplishment. Even like when we feel hungry, then, you know, just we eat the food until we get rid of that hunger. It is not that, you know, talking about food, we could get rid of the, you know, just hunger. So just talking about, oh, some foods are very delicious, good, you know, very nice taste, and just go on talking like that, we cannot just fulfill our stomach. So that when we eat and drink and just, you know, continuity of that, and then we just, you know, satisfied with the, you know, just that hunger, and it goes away. So in this way, first one have to know the source and history of the Dharma, And then according to that, just one try to, you know, really understand the meaning of Dharma, and then one carry through the practice that what it has been taught by the, you know, Lama, the Bajra masters, according to their, you know, instruction, not just kind of, you know, creating one's own ideas or concepts. So in that way, whatever one just understand about the Dharma teaching, then of course, you know, it is important one have to really apply into practice that which one could do, get rid of all these, you know, obscurations. Similar like, you know, we need to, what we cook the food, we really need to eat to get rid of the hunger. And as we do the practice, then possibly we could have a little bit of experience of certain kind of, you know, purification. And by that time, one should not think, oh, I have, you know, good experience, some kind of realization, and then started just, you know, giving teachings to others. That not necessarily that can, you know, benefit. And in general, that all the Dharma practices, whatever we try to do, it is very important how we can just get rid of this, you know, our ego, try to get rid of that pride, and where we have that kind of practice on, you know, just humbleness and more noble being. So Dharma practice is the actual antidote how we can get rid of all these negative emotions or afflicted minds. So Dharma is not that which increases your, you know, that negative emotions. And through the Dharma practice, that where we could, you know, just slowly get rid of all the afflicted mind or these, you know, negative passions. There is a saying in Tibetan that whoever have great deal of knowledge may have pride, and whoever have great deal of retreat and meditation have more, you know, afflicted mind.
So that
is just going against the Dharma path, you know, that one could not follow according to the Dharma practice. So in this way, all the Dharma practice or the spiritual path itself, where how we try to just mingle or mix with our own, you know, mind stream, and in that way how we could to give rise to or awaken ourselves, our own true nature, to have that kind of recognition or realization. It is not that just to boast, to just explain to somebody that, you know, I know the Dharma. So someone who is doing, you know, actual Dharma practice, whether someone is really following that properly or not, as we just, you know, see physically, you know, when they talk and how they walk, you know, through that also we can guess, you know, how much practice is there. That someone whose mind is very calm and peaceful and humble, and at the same time that there is no much, you know, affliction or these conceptual negative thoughts, you know, not arising, that is the just the result of actual practice of Dharma. So even in just Tibetan that there are also that, you know, who study a lot and have great deal of just knowledge on the Dharma, then they are just kind of like a very boastful or prideful, which means that oneself is not really applying the practice as a, you know, just a proper practice. So the actual meaning and actual saying is that whoever have more just study and understanding of the Dharma, and whoever have more knowledge, that has to be more humble and polite, and whoever has done more meditation practice or retreat, that should be just, you know, less affliction. So whether that Dharma practice could just really work in a proper way or not, it is depending upon how much we apply into our mind stream. That we how in somehow just kind of like a looking to others and then, you know, finding out somebody's fault and then blaming to other ones, that there is no anything to do with that Dharma. So somehow we are just very easy to look, you know, somebody's fault and mistakes and just saying, oh, this way of just, you know, somebody practice is not right, or that way of teaching is not, you know, proper. And then in that way, we are so habituated just for, you know, looking for the fault of others. So the actual practice of the Dharma that try to watch into oneself, you know, whether one's mind is stream or that mind, how much it is just really, you know, falling according to the Dharma teaching, and how much oneself could, you know, just really do the practice. And in that way, that it is very important how we can tame our mind and give that kind of training to ourselves before we just, you know, find something to others. For example, like our mind, even for a moment, you know, how many negative and conceptual thoughts are just, you know, arising that we could not just settle down. So in this way, you know, examining oneself and watching oneself, and then when we find that all these kind of negative thoughts and passions, you know, afflicted minds are arising, and then applying that, you know, practice, and then train one's mind and try to calm down. That is how, you know, just we do the Dharma practice, and it is very important. So Dharma, the practice is that to tame or to train one's mind, to subdue one's mind. It is not just to harm somebody. So the nature of the Dharma and the Buddhist practice is that you know, always try to generate compassion and loving kindness to all other beings, and that is the just you know, basic ground of the Dharma teaching and Dharma practice, which is just very important. There is the four dharmas of the bhikshus that which explains, you know, even somebody just insult you, you don't, you know, just insult back. Even somebody just, you know, hit you, you don't hit back again. Even somebody just find your mistake, you don't, you know, just do that same thing to others. Even that somebody is mean to you, you don't act in that way, you know, to others. That way, you know, that four dharmas, practice of the bhikshus. So So this way, you know, always try to understand and try to just train oneself. It is very important. So in one way, that all the sentient beings, whoever they are, there is no one single being who has not been once, you know, parent. So for that, if one just become, you know, angry and just creating all these kind of hateful thoughts and, you know, giving rise to negative emotions, then that also just, you know, harm other, and they also get more afflicted and deluded, and that way there is no any help, you know, it becomes just worse. It is because we all are from beginningless lifetime just got so habituated just to look for somebody's, you know, fault, and, you know, just saying something to, you know, somebody and blaming others. So that is our problem.
So
these practices, of course, you know, it is not just easy or immediately we could stop everything and just become a very noble person, but constantly thinking and, you know, watching one's thought and going through all this kind of training of mind, you know, where we try to just tame and train our mind, and that way, then, you know, there is a way, slowly, slowly, we can get better.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
Oh, yeah, thank
you.
So now first going through the Ngwando Four Foundation practice, so you all can be here.